Now, I don't know about you, but my Twitter feed is dominated by news about A68A, an iceberg that broke away from the Antarctic Peninsula in July 2017. Now, I must confess, I have a personal interest in this iceberg because I was the first person to film footage of it in December 2017 on a science flight over the Larsen C ice shelf. But why is everybody talking about an iceberg? Why should anyone care? Well, it looks like it was on a collision course for South Georgia, and that would have spelled disaster for the island's wildlife, including penguins, seals, birds, and more. In something of a Christmas miracle, it seems to have averted catastrophe, breaking up into smaller bits and veering off that course. So this is a really good news story. When it broke away in 2017, it was around 5,500 square kilometres, which is roughly the size of Delaware, quarter of the size of Wales, size of Luxembourg, four Londons or six Manhattans. That makes it one of the largest bergs in recorded history. Since it made its getaway, A68 has been following the Antarctic Circumpolar Current Front, which separates warmer waters to the north from colder waters to the south and encircles the entire Antarctic continent. In that time, it's formed into an iceberg that looks like a pointy little finger. And as of Boxing Day 2020, the fingers and knuckles have actually broken away into two smaller little baby bergs. And those are delightfully named A68E and A68F. In the time that it's taken to get from the Antarctic Peninsula to the position it's in now, A68A has lost about two-thirds of its volume, it's halved in size, it's also thinned quite a lot. It was previously around about 250 metres thick and is now somewhere in the region of 200 metres thick. The thickness of the iceberg is really important because it's that determines the draft, just like a ship, whether it can go further inland and therefore closer to the habitats that we're interested in. Two of the biggest new baby bergs, A68E and F, aka the fingers and knuckles of the pointy hand, are a little bit thinner than the rest of the iceberg, which means that they still might end up getting a bit closer to South Georgia than the main A68A chunk. The most recent satellite images show lots of rifts and cracks developing on the main iceberg A68A, which suggests that it's likely to splinter any moment now into lots of tiny little iceberg fragments by the process of hydrofracturing. And if you're interested in that process, you can find a video that I did on the subject just here. Those satellite images also show that the whole crew, A68A and pals, are starting to drift north again along the Antarctic Circumpolar Current. So although this is a good news story for South Georgia's wildlife, they're not out of the woods yet. It remains to be seen what the fate of these icebergs and therefore the wildlife of South Georgia will be, but it seems like these icebergs won't be staying whole for long. So watch this space.